Listen to the river, does it make you wonder how anything could ever stand still? First lightning and then thunder, thunder. The kiss in the rain, love, feel the thrill.
Benjamin Franklin said, "How few there are who have courage enough to own their faults or resolution enough to mend them." And then Cicero said, "It is the peculiar quality of a fool to perceive the faults of others and to forget his own. You can't clear your own fields while you're counting the rocks on your neighbor's farm." Happy Friday. Welcome back to another episode of Morning Coffee with your host, Rick Alexander. I hope your Friday is off to a good start and you're looking forward to the weekend. Whether that weekend includes pacifying yourself from a life that you simply tolerate, or it includes looking into bigger horizons, trying to expand your own consciousness so that you can create the life that you no longer have a need to get away from. Or maybe you've already done that and you are just on the constant path of improvement, which is where I feel like I am. I'd be happy to talk to you in all three ways. You know, the point of this show really is to just help you make sense of this thing that we call life and to help you draw your own conclusions so that you know how to spend the next 48 hours of your life and so that you do so with your eyes open, regardless of what you choose. And you know, as I've gone through this life thing and I've sort of reflected on my different experiences, I've started to figure something out about relationships. And of course, remember, your entire life is a relationship. It's a subject-object relationship. You, being the subject, have a relationship to everything that objects to your awareness. And of course, everything that objects is what we call the world around you. And so your relationship with the world around you is the thing that's going to dictate the quality of your life. When it comes to interpersonal relationships, be those romantic, be those platonic, be those professional, whatever it looks like, your ability to navigate those relationships and show up as your best self is probably the thing that's going to dictate the quality of your life the most, which is why, as of recently, I've started talking a little bit more about relationships. It's something we're all going through all the time and something we're all aware of, and so it's something that I think we need to put a little light on. Well, the other thing that I've started to figure out as I've explored the human psyche and maybe what the hell we're doing here in this life thing, the other thing that I've started to figure out is that you have a scared little kid inside of you. We all do, right? Usually it's the form of the ego. And if you haven't gone through some sort of ego death, then essentially it's probably built a really strong case for itself and your ego's actually grown and gotten larger. And the more it grows, the more shadows it creates. And when I talk about a shadow, I mean there are going to be characteristics of your humanity that exist outside of your awareness. Those are shadows. The reason you want to be aware of those is so that you actually know and are aware of the things that you're doing to the people that are around you. And if you don't become aware of your shadows, then the ego will continue to build its case and it will continue to run your life. And you will think everything's fine and everybody else around you will see what's wrong with you. But getting back to the original problem, the ego, it operates like a scared little kid. It's afraid to let go of what it knows to be true. And so sometimes when you get in relationships, what relationships do is they kind of hold up a mirror to, well, what I'm starting to realize is that they hold up a mirror to the quality of your character. And so if the quality of your character is suffering, your relationships are going to suffer. And so what happens when you get in a relationship, if you haven't gone through some sort of ego death and you haven't become aware of your shadows and your own faults and your own shortcomings, things that we all have and that there's nothing to be ashamed of, if you don't become aware of those things, then what happens is because your ego blinds you to the shadows of your own personality, what you do is you end up pointing those things out in everybody else. And so if you're in a relationship and you start feeling insecurities pop up, the first thing that you're going to do, if you've not done the proper work to integrate your personality and understand how your ego works, what's going to happen is those insecurities are going to pop up and you're going to look for reasons to make yourself feel better. And that's going to come in the form of projecting your shadows onto somebody else. And so if you have a problem in a relationship, whatever that problem is, whether it's insecurity or fear or something along those lines, you should always first seek to find out what's wrong within yourself. Because the chances are that that is a reflection of yourself, because your relationship is a reflection of the quality of your character. And so if you don't identify your own demons before pointing out the demons in others, you're going to fuck your life up. The reason is because you're going to act on misinformation. You're acting on projections. You're acting on parts of your character that you don't understand or see. And so, again, anytime resistance comes up in your life in a relationship, what I've learned is that the first thing you have to do is ask yourself what might be going wrong with you. There's a rift somewhere between your mind and between your actions. And somewhere that rift is causing dissonance and it's starting to get to you. And so if your ego is too built up, you're going to project that dissonance and those problems onto somebody else. And you're just going to look for the problem in them. The problem is that you're a lot better off if the problem is you and not the world around you. Because there's little you can do about fixing the world. There's a lot you can do about fixing yourself. And that's why you always look for your own demons first. Because if you're having a problem in life, if there's some dissonance or some resistance or something going on in your life that you don't like, you'd better hope the problem is you. Because if the problem's the world, you've got a real uphill battle. But if the problem is you and the way that you're integrated in the world, well, shit, that's something you can fix. That's something that you have control over. And so that is the fundamental reason why an entitlement mentality doesn't help people grow, because it rejects that anything is wrong with you. You feel entitled to a certain situation. But again, how hard is it to change the world around you? Instead, look for your own demons. So the question to ask yourself today is, in relation to all of the struggles I'm having in all of the different relationships in my life, where might I be the problem? That's going to be your answer, because that's the thing that you can fix. That's something you can do something about. Oftentimes, we don't want to do something about that because undergoing the death of an ego can be really scary. But with that comes the knowledge that if you don't die, you can't be born again. And so you'll remain in the state that you're at. The problem with that is that you have a problem with the state that you're at. That's why there's trouble in your relationships. That's why it's so important to undergo an ego death. And that's why it's so important to find your own demons and confront them. No matter how uncomfortable it will be, it will always be more comfortable than trying to change the world around you just so that you can avoid your own internal demons. I hope you spend a little bit of time, maybe this weekend, just thinking about that, thinking about ways you can fix yourself, because it's like I said in a previous episode, right? Like how much better might the world be if you were better? The answer is we don't really know. So it's a process. Potential is an ongoing well that you have the ability to tap into. I hope that you start this weekend by tapping into that potential, by seeing what's going on with your own character and your own personality, and then owning your flaws and then projecting that into the world. That is a much better way to go about changing your life. At least that's what I found. Love you guys. Have an amazing weekend. We'll talk Monday on Morning Coffee.
Tonight we drink to youth and holding fast to truth. Don't wanna lose what I had as a boy.